Hey, good morning, Minecrafters. It's Minecraft Grand, the Geeky Minecrafter, coming at you with another video. And today, we're building a mob farm. And while most people will show you progress and everything looking great, I'm gonna differ a little bit. I'm going to show you what happens when you're not paying attention and you miscount before, let's just say it's wrong. It's so wrong. I'm off by 4 blocks in every direction, and this is just not going to work. I'm going to wind up having to use twice as many hoppers as I'd planned to use, and, you know, who has that kind of iron just laying around? So I'm going to show you where we're at. Now, one of the first things I did, as you can see, I've come off the tower. I came 20 blocks this way. I came 20 blocks up, and I created a platform. From the platform, I've come up 40 blocks. And created another platform. Let me just make sure there's no... Yep. Okay. Created this other platform. Now, I have had a lot of help. Yeti the Vetti has been up here helping. And I miscounted from the center line here. I thought it was supposed to be, you know, 11 this way, 11 this way. And it turns out that's so wrong. So let me show you, where we're really at. And then I'm going to have to take it all down and start over. So basically, from the dispenser, I need to go 8 spaces. So, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so this little bit of brown wood is the distance. Then you skip 2. This is going to be the opening that goes from here to here. And then you go 8 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so this is where it should be, and this is where I had it. Okay, so I'm needing to move it in 3 spaces, and then when I got down here, I realized that there's supposed to be 4 in between. Okay, and I did not have 4 in between from here down, and I had to move this wall out 2 as well. So it's just a hot mess, and if we look at it, see they don't line up, and they should. It's just ridiculous. So this one's got to move. All of these have got to move down. So I'm gonna go tear this down, and I'm gonna check back in with you. Okay, isn't that special? Okay, I think I have it laid out right. Let me take you over and show you what I've wound up with. So I've moved everything in on one side. Basically, I'm leaving the structure the way it was on the outside. I'm the only one that's gonna know that it's there. Well, you guys too, but I'm the only one that's really going to nerve. I'll leave the outside the way it is. I've moved everything in on the inside. I will re-wall the, you know, I'll continue this wall up. Now remember that I'm having more than 2 levels, and right now there are only 2 levels, and I'm glad I caught it when I did, and I didn't have to do this for all 4 levels. But basically, you know, the goal is to have 4 levels of mob farm, and that's, you know, that's a lot of wood. I hate doing the 2 walls, but, you know, it was that or tear everything down, and I'm just... You know, I respect my axe too much to do that. So, I'm not entirely trusting the server right now. It's kicked me like 6 times in a row while I'm up here in crouch mode on the narrow beam. Okay, I don't mind telling you that, you know, that's scary stuff. So, I'm going to continue. Oh, gosh. I hate having to reload my inventory while I'm on a beam. But I think I'm gonna do that. Let's see, I believe. Yeah, this one, there we go. So I've got to have some wiring back here, and I'm just going to use this as a chase for the wiring that goes to each of these. Not loving it. It's double the wood on the outer walls, but you know, it beats what my alternative is. So I do have a chase that I can get in. I'm going to need to create a ladder up there. Anyway, Basically, my torch tower is going to come up, you know, one of these two right here on the outside edge here. And the wiring will go all the way around and connect all of these dispensers to one switch, to one torch tower, so that when the clock fires, it ignites all of the dispensers. The dispensers flow the water. The water pushes all of the mobs out to the center. Now, right now it's solid because I'm not interested in falling off of this really high tower. But when it's all done and I begin taking the scaffolding down, there will be kind of like a jaw pattern or a tooth pattern right through the center here where the water flows to the edge and then stops. So right here, for example, you know, this one will be out, but it'll move over one. That one will be out. That one will be out. That one will be out. So, you know, the way this water works, you know, when you have them four together like this, you kind of get a jaw pattern, and that jaw pattern is where they're going to fall. So what I'll do is drop sand or gravel through the jaw pattern once I've cut it. That'll let me know on the platform that I still need to build below where exactly the hoppers are going to need to be. Now, of course, I'm going to extend them out a little bit, but you know, there's no reason for it to go too wide. And that's what we would have had. If I hadn't moved this wall in, I would need literally twice as many hoppers as I'm going to be using. So, okay, that's where I'm at. I'm going to continue building. I may just shut up, put some music on, and go from there. Okay. It seems I underestimated how much dark oak was going to be needed. I am down to 19 planks. And I think I have a little bit in the chest down below. But the bottom line is I don't have near enough to finish. So I'm going to take five. I'm going to make sure I'm not the only one up here. Let's leave this in here. I need room in my inventory to carry some stuff up. So let's go get some dark oak. Okay, I believe the floor is done. Okay, so this is actually the roof here. I have dispensers all along the first floor. I have my cutout in the center. Now, I'm not gonna chew all this wood up and put it in the form that the water's gonna take just yet. I'm gonna try to do this, you know, in survival mode, obviously. So I can't pull all this stuff out. I can't test it even because that'll knock all my torches out, and then this becomes a mob chamber. So I'm going to go build the platform down below. This is okay. Let me back up. This is level one, level two, level three. So I've decided to go with three rather than four, mostly because it has taken significantly more wood than I thought it would. So I'm going to stop it at three. I'm going to wind up owing Yeti the Vetti quite a bit of dispensers, so I might as well just stop here. I'm going to, like I said, jump downstairs. Let me make sure there's nobody up here. And build the platform that goes down here. Now, before I jump down there, I need these hoppers and the rest of these dispensers. Where's the hoppers? The rest of the iron. Now, I had 11 buckets left over. I wish I hadn't made them, but, you know, what are you going to do? Yeah, I had already done that. So I'm going to come back up here for the rest of this. I'll leave this for now. And let's go build a platform. Again. Ah, I always feel like I'm going to fall. So I only have to build it 24 down. That'll kill them. I had my original design also spawned witches and endermen. And this is before I knew that endermen, you know, hated water, and as soon as the water started flowing, they would teleport out. So I forgot to update my notes, and when I was looking at my notes on how to build it, I just went up 40. It's completely unnecessary. I actually could have done the platform at 20. Now, I am going to go up 10 so that I can build all this underneath as my sorting room, the AFK station, all like that. So I'm going to mark it. This is 10. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, this is hard to see. Yeah, see? Okay. Now, the other one, what I did when I built it, every 10th brick or block was a different color. I wish I'd done that here. Let me take a moment and put that platform in there and this platform in here. Okay, I'm back, and I've done a little small test fire. Let me show you what I've got on over here. Basically, what I did was I cut myself an access panel right back here. This makes me nervous. Let me just throw a couple little somethings up here so I don't fall off. Because, God help me, I'm just not very coordinated. What I did was run blocks over where the dispensers are, run redstone, and I put a lever in here to test it. I let the water run, and then I marked where the water ends with these lighter color blocks. Now, I did this, and I need to come back in here and light it up, because when I turned the water on, it washed all my torches away. So now I have a pattern that I can just duplicate all the way down. And I cut the channel so that I could watch the water. And basically, it did okay. So I'm going to finish wiring this up. Let me take you downstairs and show you what I've done down there. This one. Oh, come on. That scared me. Okay, so I've run the torch tower up, and I will take this center post out. Basically, I just used it to get up there. Now, see, the torch tower goes all the way up. Just follow this on down. And again, it's not wired in upstairs, but I tested it here. You can see it turning off and turning on. So basically, I'm going to have a clock right down here that's going to do the same thing as this button. It's going to press it and pulse the water dispensers, hold them open for just a few seconds, long enough to wash the mobs off the edge, and then it's going to turn back off and reset the clock. So that's where I'm at. I'm still wiring things up. Let's see, I came down to get some more of this. I'm almost out of redstone. Let's see. We'll go ahead and do this. This is not a silk touch. Yes, it is. Where's my non-silk touch? Oh, of course. Is it downstairs? Naturally? Okay. Well, hopefully it's right up here. If not, maybe I've got some more redstone up here. I've got a lot of scaffolding that's going on over here. I really need to start taking some of this out. It's getting kind of out of control. Oh my gosh, I thought I fell. That was scary. Okay, so this torch is going to light things on this level, right? So if there's redstone here, see how this torch fires it. So I'm actually going to need this to follow around. Let's see. Oh, goodness. Turbo torch here, or turbo here. You know what? I don't guess I need it all the way around, do I? Will it flow down? It will. Oh, repeaters. That was the other thing I meant to make. I was downstairs. Oh, yeah. Okay, let's break that for right now. And let's break this for right now. Oh, shoot. Okay, let's put that back on for just a second. Oh, I've got them reversed. Good grave. There we go. Yeah, it is all about putting them on in order and making sure that you don't blow that part. Let's keep going down here. I put torches so I'd know where they were supposed to be. Oops, that's not where that goes. Who said you could go there? Oh, no. Hello. I want to keep that. I want to put that there. Now, the signal is not going to reach all the way down here, so I'm going to need a set of repeaters on each level that extends the signal. And I'm going to need to do some counting. I'm going to need to do this same wiring on each floor, and it's going to come off this same torch tower. Okay? Continue the torch tower. I think that's got to be... Oh, goodness. Okay. That makes me a little nervous. I think I have a ladder. I do. A ladder going up right here. So, that's this one. Here. This one here. And you know what? That's going to be right inside the chamber. It's going to let sunlight in, which is going to affect my spawn rates. So maybe what I'll do is just cover. Okay, I temporarily need to walk outside here. Goodness. Goodness. This makes me nervous. Okay, this is the level. This level right here. Well, that's good news. That means I can put some redstone right here. And just flow that around. Oh, good grief. I did not bring near enough redstone up here. Okay, what's this? This is how I got down. Okay, I'm going to head back to the base and get some more redstone because God knows we're going to need quite a bit. I'll go ahead and make some repeaters while I'm down there. Isn't that interesting? Okay, so I'm going to get started building the chase because it's really interfering with my redstone. I think it's four out from this line right here. So one, two, three, four, and then it turns. Now, I may wind up moving this since this is now in my mechanical room. Criminy. Not gonna have room. Yeah, okay. Let me think about this a second. When I get up there, what's gonna happen? Am I going to be able to get back over to the ladder? I think I am. Okay, so I tell you what, I'm actually going to shorten it. I'm going to go one in. I need more room here for the mechanical room. Remember, this is where the clock is going to be. So I need that to have enough room there. Okay, here we go. Out of good grief. Okay. Isn't that special? Okay, I need to crawl down. I was not prepared. Are you ready for that? I know you're surprised, right? It's not very far, but I don't want to jump it. It's not like I have the extra hearts to give up. You know what, maybe I'll make the chase from there up. That way that gives me back my mechanical room. Maybe. Yep, let's do that. Okay, let's offload some of this. I've got 90% of the redstone done. I've got just a few little pieces that I need to do. Oh, I am going to need that. Goodness, I spend a lot of time organizing. Have you ever noticed that? Is that just because I'm anal retentive? Could that be it? Baby. Okay, up we go. Now I reserve the right to pull this part of the chase down. And just do it from here. Actually, you know what? If I'm going to do it from here, can I reach that? No? That gives me one wide to be inside. I think that'll work. Having a chase in there. That way I can do my redstone torch. I can do any kind of alterations that I need to do. Keep the ladders in there. I mean, ideally, if I've done this right, I don't have to go back in here. You know what I'm saying? I shouldn't have to. But sure as I don't provide a way, I'll need it. So I'm going to go ahead and provide a way. That way I won't need it. Okay, let's get rid of this. Okay, so this is going to wind up being the chase right here. Oh, I didn't think this all the way through, did I? How am I going to build that other side up and be able to get over here? Well, okay. Should go ahead and put the ladder in on the chase. That's what I should do. Let's step right here. Come on. Whew. Just not the best at ladders. But you knew that about me. Okay, so you probably don't want to see me screaming and falling. So I'm going to pause it and finish building the chase. I'll be back in a minute. Hey there, it's Minecraft Gran again, continuing the mob farm. So I thought, you know, I was working in the sorting room and I thought I'd stop and give you a progress update. So here's what's going on. I'm on that main platform. You remember the original one that I built once I came up the 20 blocks from the bridge. The mob farm is up there. The splat pad is up there, and then this is the pad where the drops are going to come down and flow through the sorting system. And I realized that, you know, this is an above ground sorting system that I thought I'd take a moment to show you. But before we do that, let's show you the progress that I've made. Now, this is a lot of hoppers. I have exhausted my iron. I have bought a bunch of iron from somebody in town, and I have begun hollowing out the area where they're going to fall. Now, if you remember from earlier, I do have a challenge over there on that side. I had built it off center and had to make some adjustments. Otherwise, I was going to have to add like 6 more rows, 4 on one side and 2 on the other. 6 more rows of hoppers, and that was just too many. So rather than do that, I did move everything over, and I do have a hollow on one side of the farm, and I'm okay with that. Again, this is more about getting the mob drops than anything else. So I have finished this one. Okay, see how see how that goes. Now, the first time this fires, it's going to wash all those torches down. I just didn't want anybody spawning in here until I was ready. So that's done. The wiring is done all the way around. And that includes into this chase that I was telling you about. So, you know, I had to move it this much over. It's actually three blocks because there's another block on the other side of this. Now, I do have, like I said, this is the top one. So let me show you this one. See how this one still has water in it? That's because I haven't finished hollowing all this out. And I'm not going to turn the water off until I'm ready to do that, because mobs can't spawn on water. And I have the areas where it's not water very well lit up. So when I'm ready, I'll knock this switch off. Well, I'll flip it once to turn the water off. Then I'll knock the switch off. Then I will cut all of these blonde blocks out, and then go up one more to the next level. Now this one, how do I get in from here? Oh, you know, I can get in from down here, sorry. You see this? Okay, this goes up to the next level. Just like the level below, it's got running water and the cutouts that I haven't yet made. Oh, and this is what I've been dealing with. It just keeps doing this to me. I'm not sure what's going on. Good grief. Okay. So we're going up and out or down and out? Whew. That's not good. That could be a fall. Yeah, okay. So mental note, be careful when going up and down that ladder because because it could fall. This is the one, I believe, that goes all the way down. Yes, it is. Okay, so that's where we're at up here. The wiring is done. I just have a little bit of wood to knock out, and the rest of the area to close up. So I finished this up here. I don't think I'm gonna do anything here. Nobody's really gonna see this except me. I may put a little side on it so I quit almost falling off, but other than that, I don't think I'm gonna do anything else. And you can't see from under here, but that area where they fall, that is off center, and I guess I'm just gonna have to live with that. Okay, so let's recap the sorting room. It's a T of blocks, repeaters pointing into this block. Up here it's all redstone, except for this row. This row is where the comparators are gonna be, because we've got a bunch of hoppers to go here. Okay, up from up above, I've got this hopper is the one that comes down through the floor. I've moved it over and brought it along this line, but I now see, now that everything is built, I'm actually going to have to bring it over one more. So what I may do is jump up there, drop it over, and then bring it down. This is my input line, and will contain the flow of items into the chest. Now, I've built chests for TNT, or gunpowder, bones, arrows, spider webs, spider eyes, and the rest of it I can just flow into a bunch of overflow chests that I don't care about. I'll probably put together some kind of disposal system to get rid of the things that I don't want. So the things I really care about most are spider web, spider eye, and TNT. The bones, the arrows I can get from the Skelly Farm, so I'm not in huge need for that. I'm getting hungry. Let's eat some pumpkin pie. It's the new year, so pumpkin pie on New Year's Day, that's always fun. Okay, so in looking at my inventory, I don't have any comparators. I need some nether quartz. I haven't found anybody. I've been asking online, and nobody seems to have any. So I'm going to need to go downstairs to the spawn and see if I can't buy some. So let me throw some of this stuff up here. Stuff I don't want to run around with. Chest 2. Okay, and let's go to spawn and see if I can find stuff. Well, Peach, thank you so much. While I was paused, I asked again if anybody had any, and Peach offered me some. I offered to buy it, but he said he wasn't needing it. So Peach gave me, looks like 32, and that's going to be enough to finish what I need to do here. So we need, let's do like this, and like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, nope, 7. Okay, let's do a few more of these. I don't need many, but let's see what we can make here. Okay, 11. 11 should do it, and I'll have some spare. Yay! Okay, thanks again, Peach. I really appreciate you. Okay, so this is the comparator goes right here, and it's going to go right up against this hopper. Now, I need to probably finish my hopper chain, bring that down where it needs to go. I do still have them, okay? I'm sorry. I have a little bit of a sniffle. I think my allergies are trying to kick up here. Let's take some of this netherrack. Because that's like a one-hit wonder. It makes great scaffolding. Okay, so let's do this. Let's go... Okay, what I need to do is pull it over one more, like that. So, we're just kind of zigzagging down. Let's do... I actually probably don't need that one. Okay, so... Hopper, hopper, right? Am I down far enough? Let's go see. And remember, this is my input. So I'm down on this level. Oh, I may have come down one too far. Oh, now I feel like an idiot. I was supposed to put these hoppers in first. Let's see if I can do this. Oh, good grief. Okay, so the hopper goes here, pointing into the chest. Each one of these. Okay, this is how it gets through the filter. Now, on top of this, and this is where I need a temporary block. Let's do a block here. Oh, no, hello. Block here. And then... like this. Okay, this one points into this block. This is going to be the filter line. And then this is the input line. So this one's going to go right above that. Okay, a couple more up. And this, you know what? This one is going to go like this. It's going to feed into that block. So like this. So it flows across. Come on, come on. Okay, so I need to get from here to here. Let's make a little more scaffolding. Okay, from here. Come on, come on. Oh, I can't get through there. Okay, let's try that. Did that work? Looks like I have one going the wrong direction here. Yep, see that one goes down and it should go into there. So let's move that. Try this one more time. Okay, point it into there. Come on, come on, into that. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so let's just review. Let me get my scaffolding out of the way, make sure this is all correct. I do need some stairs too, so I'll be able to open these chests. And this one here is going to drop down into the overflow. Okay, so the input line starts here, goes across, comes down, goes across, comes down, goes across. So what I need are some filter elements in this center one. I need the comparators right up here. So do I still have my stone? I do. Okay, so we get a block there and a block there. It's going to be right on top of those torches. We got some redstone that goes here. And the comparators go right here, facing this direction. Three, four, five. Okay, now the sorting room in my other mob farm had, I believe it was 10 of these, but it was for additional mob drops. One of the things I did in that other one was I made it 3 high instead of 2 high like I did here. So I got witches. I got Endermen, but they teleported out as soon as the water flowed. I got a few more drops from that other one. But again, the only ones I really care about are the TNT, or rather the gunpowder. Bones and arrows, I won't throw them away because you can always use those. Spider webs and spider eye for my potions. So I think that's going to do it. Let's do this. Let's go ahead and set up our overflow chest, right? Right into there, okay. Yeah, I probably could have done that a little bit more gracefully, but hey, you know. Okay, so this one. And we can do this one down, right? Huh. Okay, well. Bring it down. You know what? I think I'm going to bring this right down into an overflow chest that sits here. What do you think? Well, not loving it, but I may choose to do something different with that in a little bit. Okay, so I need some stairs to cover this up, some item frames, you know, a few things like that. But let's go see now that it's wired up and I've got a way to capture everything. I don't have any of the filtering in that goes in here. I need an anvil and something that I can name to put in there. I think we're ready to wire up the clock. Now, that bit is a little bit complicated, so what I think I'll do is I will bid you adieu. We're going to call this episode a wrap. I have finished quite a bit of the mob farm. The clock is going to be a little bit complicated, like I said, so let's do that in its own episode. So I think that's it. This is Minecraft Grand, the geeky Minecrafter, signing out. Stay tuned for the next episode, where I'll build a clock that'll set up my water dispensers that are located up there on the mob farm level to flow and wash the mobs down onto the splat pad right up there. And then once they die, it'll flow into this across and will be sorted right here. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Happy mining!